Hello guys, welcome back to Chenda DIY. And today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a granny square crop top. It is a really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. For this crop top, it is for size small and size medium. Okay, now let's get into the video. First, we are going to make the granny square. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 3. After you got 3 chains, then we are going to make slip stitch into the first chain to create the circle. To make slip stitch, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. So for this hole, it is the center of the circle. And then continue pull the yarn through this last loop. And now you have created a circle for granny square. Next, for row 1, chain 3. So for chain 3, we also count as a stitch. Then make 2 double crochet stitch into the center of the circle to make the double crochet. Yarn over. Insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. Make 1 more double crochet stitch. In total, you must have 3 stitches, include the chain 2 stitch. Next, chain 2. After you got 2 chains, then make 3 double crochet into the center of the circle. So for this short strand of yarn, you have to carry it along with the row. After you got 3 double crochet into the same stitch, then chain 2 and repeat the same thing by make 3 double crochet into the same stitch, then chain 2 for 2 more times, then I will meet you back again. After you got 4 groups of the border shade, then we are going to make slip stitch into the chain 3 stitch. So you must have 2 loops on your hook, like so. Then yarn over and pull through all the loops. And this is what the first row of the square looks like. As you can see, we have 4 groups of the border shade stitch. Next, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Don't forget to pull and stretch it a little bit. For the center string of yarn, you can cut it off. So when you flip it, this is the back side of the square or the wrong side of the stitch. And this is the right side of the stitch or the right side of the square. Turn your work to the wrong side of the stitch and we are going to weave the end of the yarn into these stitches. Insert the hook into both loops. As you can see. And then yarn over and pull through the loops. Keep repeating this into the next loop. And for this chain 2, we only insert the hook into one loop. And now you are done weaving the yarn. And this is what it looks like. Next, for row 2, we are working on the wrong side of the stitch. So turn your work and attach the yarn into the chain 2 space or the corner part. Hold these 2 strands of yarn and then chain 1. Then drop this short strand of yarn and continue make 2 more chains. In total, you must have 3 chains. So for this chain 3, also count as a stitch. Next, we are going to make 2 stitches of the border shade into the same stitch with chain 3. After you got 3 stitches, then chain 2. And make 3 double crochet into the same stitch. Next, we are going to repeat the same thing into the other loop or into the other chain 2 space by making 3 double crochet into the same stitch. Then chain 2 and make 3 more double crochet into the same stitch. In total, you must have 2 groups of double crochet stitch into the same loop. And this is how we create the corner of the square. Keep repeating this into every chain 2 space around until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the chain 3 stitch to connect the row. Count 1, 2 and insert the hook into the 3rd chain. Like I said, you must have 2 loops on your hook. Then yarn over and pull through all the loops. Next, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Stretch it a little bit to give a nice shape. Next, we are going to change the color. And this is what the second row of the square looks like. Next, turn your work and cut off the remaining yarn that we carry along with the row. Turn the square into the wrong side of the stitch and we are going to weave in the remaining yarn like we did in the first row. Remember, we always turn the square into the wrong side of the stitch when we start the new row. For row 3, attach the yarn into the chain 2 space. And we are going to repeat the same thing like we did in the previous row by grab 2 strands of yarn and chain 1. Then drop the short strand of yarn and continue make 2 more chains. In total, you must have 3 chains. Then make 2 double crochet more into the same stitch with chain 3. After you got 3 stitches, then chain 2. Next, make 3 more double crochet into the same stitch. Next, we are going to make 3 double crochet into the next loop. after you got three double crochet into the same stitch. Next, for the chain 2 space, we are going to make the corner for the square by make 3 double crochet into the same stitch. Then chain 2. Then make 3 more double crochet into the same stitch. Like I said, in total, you must have 2 groups of double crochet with chain 2 stitch or chain 2 space. Remember, we always create this corner stitch into the chain 2 space only. Keep repeating this around by make 3 double crochet into the same loop. And then make the corner of the square until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the chain 3 stitch. Next, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the third row of the square looks like. Turn the square and cut off the remaining yarn like we did in the previous row. Then weave in the end of the yarn. Next, for row 4 is the last row of the square. I'm going to change to the main color. For my main color, it is the sand color. And for row 4, we also made the same thing like row 3. First, attach the yarn into the corner part or the chain 2 space, then chain 3. And make 2 double crochet into the same stitch with chain 3. And we are going to create the corner for the square. After you got two groups of double crochet, then we are going to make three double crochet into the next loop. After you got three double crochet, then make another three double crochet into the next loop. Next, we are going to make the corner of the square again by repeat the same thing like row 3. Keep repeating this around until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the chain 3 stitch. Next, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the fourth row of the square looks like. Turn your square and we are going to cut off the remaining yarn. For you guys that want to make the square bigger, please weave in the yarn and then start attach the yarn into the corner part or into the chain 2 space. And keep repeating the same thing like we did in row 4 by create the corner and then make 3 double crochet into every loop until you reach the chain 2 space. Then we are going to make the corner for the square again. Keep repeating around and then make slip stitch, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And for the measurement of the square, it is equal 4 inches by 4 inches. Keep repeating this for 16 squares, then I will meet you back again. Next, we are going to attach the square together. You can mix the color and for one row we have 4 squares. Turn the square wrong side out and for the right side of the square should face with each other. And we are going to attach both sides from corner to the other corner. So as you can see, this is the chain 2 space. We are going to separate these 2 chains. For the second chain, it is for this horizontal line. And for the first chain, it is for the vertical line. So you can see this V shape here, and it has 2 loops. So we only insert the hook into the first loop or into the front loops of this V stitch. And for the other square, we also separate this chain 2 also. Remember, for the second square, we only attach the yarn into the back side of the loop or into the second loop. So you must have 2 loops on your hook. Then yarn over and pull through these 2 loops. Then chain 1. Next, we are going to single crochet both sides together by make single crochet into the same stitch with chain 1. To make single crochet, insert the hook into both loops. Remember, always carry the end of the yarn along with the row. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Keep repeating this into every stitch by insert the hook into the front loop of the first square. And then continue insert the hook into the back loop of the second square. Please keep repeating this until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. So our last stitch of the row, it is the chain 2 space or chain 2 stitch. Like I said, for these 2 chains, we are going to separate 1 chain for vertical line and for 1 chain for horizontal line. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Stretch it a little bit to give a nice and straight line. And this is what the back side or the wrong side of the stitch looks like. And this is what the front or the right side looks like. As you can see, when you pick only the one loop of the V-stitch, this is what it looks like. Next, keep repeating the same thing with the other square, but turn it wrong side out and the right side face with each other. After you connected four squares together, it should look like this. Next, we are going to connect both rows together. Turn it wrong side out and we start with the corner part. Attach the yarn into the second chain of both squares. Remember, for the first square, we only pick the front loop, and for the second square, we pick the back loop. Keep making single crochet both sides together until you reach the corner part, then I will meet you back again. And this is the chain 1 remains from the separation. And for this small loop, we also attach it too. We also attach into the small loops also. and also the chain one that left from the separation. Keep repeating this into every stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then chain one and cut off the yarn. Next, repeat the same thing to the other side. If you guys want the top bigger, please add more rows of the square, or you can make the square bigger. Turn both sides wrong side out, and we are going to make single crochet both sides together. Next, turn the top right side out and we are going to make the ribbing panel around the waist. To make the ribbing panel to fit around the waist, we are going to make the crease at this both side of the top. To begin, attach the yarn into the corner part of the square. So you can see these 3 double crochet stitches, and we are going to attach the yarn into the 3rd double crochet. Make sure that you insert the hook into both loop. Then chain 2. Next, for row 1, we are going to make double crochet decrease. To make double crochet decrease, yarn over, insert the hook into the same loop with chain 2. And for this space between the square, we are going to skip it and continue insert the hook into the first double crochet. And now you can see this both 2 double crochet loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through these 2 double crochet loops. And now you got 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. Next, make double crochet into every stitch until you reach the other side of the top. Then we are going to make double crochet decrease again. Thank you. After you have made the crease, then continue make the ball crochet into every stitch until you reach the chain 2 stitch. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. Next, for row 2, chain 2 and make double crochet into the same stitch with chain 2. Next, we are going to make front post double crochet. To make front post double crochet, yarn over, we are going to insert the hook through the front post and around the post. And it should look like this on your hook and behind your hook. Then yarn over and pull a loop back through the stitch. And then you should have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through 2 loops. And yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. Next, we are going to make another front post double crochet into the next stitch. After you got 2 front post double crochet, then we are going to make back post double crochet. To make back post double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook through the back post of the stitch and around the post. Then yarn over and pull back through the stitch. You should have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. Next, make another back post double crochet into the next stitch. And now you should have 2 back post double crochet stitches.
Keep alternating front post and back post double crochet into every stitch until you have 1 last stitch. Then I will meet you back again.
After you had 1 last stitch, then we are going to make double crochet into that last stitch.
Next, make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch.
For the next row, we are going to repeat row 2 until you reach row 5, then I will meet you back again.
After you reach row 5, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. If you guys want the ribbing higher, please add more rows by repeat row 2. Next, we are going to make single crochet around this top part. To begin, attach the yarn and chain 1. Next, we are going to make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. For the next part, we are going to make the strap for the top. You guys can try the top on your body and use stitch marker to mark where you want to make the strap. To begin, attach the yarn and chain 1. Next, for row 1, make single crochet into the next 4 stitches. If you guys want the strap bigger, please add more single crochet stitches. After you got 4 stitches of single crochet, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into the next 4 stitches. Next, keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 46, then I will meet you back again. And this is what the strap looks like after you reach row 46. If you guys want the strap longer, please add more rows. For the next part, we are going to attach the strap into the back part of the top. Flip the strap wrong side out as you can see. Count 3 stitches and attach the yarn into the 4th stitch. Then chain 1 and make single crochet into both sides loop until the end of the row. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch, chain one and cut off the yarn. And this is what the strap looks like when you flip it back. Next, repeat the same thing to the other side. For the remaining yarn, please use darning needle to weave in. And now your granny square crop top is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.